Hi, Jen and Casey here with Fusion Online. Today we're looking at release work with the green spiky ball on the wall, rolling the hips and glutes out. So I'm going to give Casey this ball, and she's going to start right in the meat of her glutes, right in the center of the glutes. And she's going to start to go side to side and rolling around, just using really organic movement to start to open up and talk to this tissue of the gluteals. Now, this is something, this sequence, along with some other sequences that we do on the upper back and shoulder, we do a lot of times to warm clients up before a mat class or in the beginning of a mat class or with our privates when, you know, at the beginning of class, you want to, or a private, you want to get started, but you don't want to waste time. So if they know this sequence, they can be rolling out and you can be discussing what's going on with their body and what their goals are, et cetera, et cetera. This is also great homework for clients to be doing every day, just for a few minutes a day.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So she's getting into the glutes here, moving the tissue a bit, and she might find a tender spot that she can hold, breathe into, deep inhales and exhales. Good. Getting that trigger point to open up, right, through the pressure of the ball and also through the brain-breath connection. Good. And now let's move to the back side, right at the gluteal line, sort of at a diagonal. Mm-hmm. And notice where Casey's legs and feet are. She's a bit away from the wall, so she can leverage back into the ball to open this tissue. So, and it's not a big movement that she's going into. She's going up and down, side to side a little bit, just so she can talk to that tissue. And what I like to call this is like a little mini stretch, right? So as opposed to our traditional stretches, which are stretching the muscles at their attachments, this is going into the belly of the muscle, really talking to that, the connective tissue and the muscle, trying to really release any knots within the belly. Mm-hmm. And when you do this work a lot, then you're gonna see an improvement in your traditional Pilates stretching or your traditional gym stretching. Mm-hmm. So now let's go to the very side of the hip. So side front of the hip, kind of below that ASIS. Again, going up and down and noticing how Casey's leveraging her body again into the ball, right? And then reminding the client as they do this to try not to build tension in the facial muscles, neck, chest. So keeping that nice, easy, expansive breath going. Good. All right. And then come on off the wall. And then after they do one side, you can ask them to kind of notice the difference between the two sides, which is really nice before they go on to the second side.
Yeah, great. It's much different.
Good, good. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you soon. Bye.